Hello and welcome to another Let's Play. This is A Place for Rest, a horror game that explores the themes of eternal life. So I guess this is a browser game. There's no download button, so this little submission thing is going to probably be in the way unless there's some kind of options once we actually get into this. Your tired limbs beg for rest. You ease the soreness out while you sit and observe the dusty abode. Crooked path, not being too far from your ancestral home. Yet, long enough away that you cannot recall whose family it once sheltered in this lonely forest. You ponder the eaves sagging and bulging through the collapsed walls. The place has been picked over, though, not a lot left behind besides old Tatooine maps and torn paper screens. A little toy here and there, but they look like things from a distant time. While you stretch and sigh, you take a few moments to breathe deeply and close your eyes. Your vision returns to inspecting the remains. There hasn't been a family here for several decades from the state of things. Maybe it was a small one. I don't really recall a flood of disaster, but I suppose it's normal to move to the city. Opportunity struck elsewhere, it seems. Your eyes catch the hole made between two shoji doors, one holding the other up, slanted together. Curiosity strikes like a match, lighting up your mind to find what remains behind. The doors crumble behind you, letting the faint light through to emulate the space. Compared to the rest of the dwelling, it is fairly good shape. You see that familiar cabinet, the doors reveal the beauty of what once was. A tiny altar, no other photos except the large one in the back. Everything's covered in a thick coat of dust, you can't help but try to tidy a little. Cleaning, dusting, and lovingly caring for the memories of those that had left our family behind. A fondness warms you from inside, compared to the chill that nips at your feet and hands. You sigh softly, mixed feelings bubbling up in your throat. The guilt weighs heavily on your heart. You cleaned up this unkept abandoned altar. The occluded figure in the frame, looking back at you, patiently to arrange the remains of the altar. Who knows how long this place has been abandoned? I can't just leave it like this. At least that wouldn't be the right thing to do. I'll tidy up the little space. This must have been someone's grandparent. Maybe they stayed until it was their time to say goodbye. I just think I know how Nana does it. She taught me, but... You stop and scratch the back of your head while you try to remember. You've seen her do this a million times. You figure intuition is the best you have for now. Luckily, your hiking bag has a few things. There's a small drawer, too, with musty incense, candles, and wet matches. You still have your lighter. One by one, the memories come back. First, the candles. It's so dark in here, and at least I'll be able to see what I'm doing. You speak out more, as if you were conversing with the figure underneath the layer of thick dust. A leftover onigiri. I have an apple too. Hopefully this incense can still light. You squint and try to think which place is best to leave the offerings. Gently wiping away the front of the fragile frame with your handkerchief dipped in a little water. You can see a demure woman standing in a garden. Her austere robes indicate she must have been born from the turn of the last century. A little piece of history, your eyes poring over the details left. The photo has been a victim to that humid rot that eats away at most things that are left out in the elements. Her face is also quite faded. You can only make out a few features. She seems beautiful and charming. A little mysterious, perhaps. She died young. This kimono is the kind that young ladies wear. Resting the clean frame back in its place, You apologize for being a little clumsy at this. Perhaps there is a god that is called by one of your confused mumbles. You grumble and give up. Curly didn't memorize any sutras. You hope the effort counts at least for something. Resting the prayer beads on the table for now. Frustrated, you start to pick through your bags to see if there isn't anything else you could offer this dignified spirit. The air is filled with quaking tension. Making your stomach turn. You clutch at your precious belongings. Your eyes dart everywhere, noticing this once quiet room is now covered in stains. The stench makes your nose hurt, and the hairs on the back of your neck stand on end. Your mind is churning from panic. Your body's too frozen to move a single inch. Why haven't I returned? My body is gone, yet I am still here. When will I escape hell? The words scratch inside the sides of your skull. You're not brave enough to respond. And you, what are you doing here? Has this woman been damned? Is this what it's like to be sent to the depths? Am I feeling her awful pain? I wish it would stop. Just stop. Clutching at the sides of your head, you cower into a little ball, closing your eyes, waiting for it all to stop. The rush of pain courses through your body, and you don't do anything to make it in. Howls chase you. Screams rattle and shake the abode. You can feel whatever entity is housed here has been aroused completely. This is not the end. Hell awaits us all. Truly believing it was the end for you, shuddering in disbelief when you open your eyes. You see the light shining through the crumbling wall. Her words seemed fortuitous. Was this an omen for trespass? The air cleared. You can breathe safely. For some reason, you now feel an old rusted key sitting in the palm of your sweaty hand. Made by Baghetti. Alright, I guess that's the end. So there you go, there's a place for rest. Very atmospheric game. It was pretty interesting. I wonder what happened to the woman. I wonder what the key is supposed to represent. But there you go. Hope you enjoyed the video, and I hope to see you next time. Take care, everybody. Later.